Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from Dimensions Guntur. To discuss the explanation for the quantitative questions from the CGL 35th paper, let us discuss the first question. The question is, without actual division, find which of the following numbers are divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 10, 11. We need to check the divisibility rules of 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 10, 11 to find the required answer. See, among the numbers, we need to find a number which is divisible by all the given numbers. That means, in the given set of numbers, 10 is there. That means, we need to find out a number from the options which is divisible by 10. A number is divisible by 10 if its last digit is 0. So, among the options, only option C have the last digit as 0. So, maybe your answer is either C, if not, it may be D. So, to confirm whether it is C or not, we need to check the divisibility rules of each and every number. Okay, so last digit is 0, so divisible by 2. Last two digits are 20, so last two digits are the multiple of 4, so it is divisible by 4. So, okay, sum of the digits is multiple of 9, so divisible by 9 as well as 3. In the same manner, we can check the divisibility rules for each and everything, so your answer is option C. Okay, then the next one is 52nd problem. For this problem, a certain number when divided by 899 leaves 63 as remainder. So if we divide a number with 899, as per the problem, 63 is the remainder. So we will write this number as n is equals to 899 into some k plus 63. Now they asked us to find the remainder when the same number is divided by 29. See, among this 899, we have 29. We can express this 899 as 29 into 31 of k plus, and this 63 as 58 plus 5. See, 58 is 29 twos. So, among all these things, 29 is the common one. So, 29 into some m plus 5 is n. Since n can be expressed as multiple of 29 plus 5, 5 is the remainder when n is divided by 29. There is the problem. Okay. And the next one is 53rd problem. The given equations are 3x plus 5y is equals to 0 and kx plus 10y is equals to 0. Find the value of k such that the system has a non-zero solution. If since the given right-hand side is 0, we need to find out the system has a non-zero solution. So, to get a non-zero solution for the system, corresponding coefficients must be in the same ratio. Here, the ratio between 5 and 10 is 1 is to 2. Ratio between 3 and k must be 1 is to 2. So, the value of k is 6. There is the problem, right? And the next one is 54th problem. For this 54th problem, the average of 5 consecutive odd numbers is given as 61. 5 consecutive odd numbers. Suppose one number is k. The difference between two consecutive odd numbers is what? 2. So, its before number is k minus 2. Next number is k plus 2. And before that one is k minus 4. Next number is k plus 4. Okay. Actually, in the question, they gave the average of all these numbers is 61. And they asked us to find the difference between the highest and the lowest numbers. Highest number is k plus 4. Lowest number is k minus 4. If you find the difference between k plus 4 and k minus 4, directly it will be k plus 4 minus of k minus 4. On simplification, you get it as 8. Okay? There is no use with the 61. Without using the 61 also, we found the difference between the highest and the least number as 8. Your answer is 8. There is the problem. Okay? And the next one is 55th problem. The cost price of 15 tables is equal to the selling price of 20 tables. We need to find out the last percentage. Okay. Cost price of some 15 articles is selling price of 20 articles. Then last percent or profit percent is nothing but what? The difference value 20 minus 15 is 5 and the number of articles with the selling price into 100. If you simplify, you will get it as 25%. Okay. And your answer is 25%. There is the problem. And the next one is 56th problem. For this 56th problem, find the amount to be paid back, a loan of 18,000 at 5.5% per annum for 3 years. We need to calculate the amount. Amount that was paid back is nothing but principal, which is 18,000 plus interest. What is the interest? 18,000 with the interest rate of 5.5 and for a period of 3 years divided by 100. If you simplify, directly you will get the amount we have to pay back. The direct question from the simple interest. And the next one is 57th one. Find the compound interest on 8,000 rupees at 15% per annum for 2 years, 4 months, compounded annually. Okay, the time period is given as 2 years, 4 months. So, we need to calculate for 2 years and then we have to calculate for the remaining 4 months. Okay, see, then we have to calculate the compound interest. First of all, we need to calculate the amount. Amount in compound interest is nothing but principal. But 8,000 into 1 plus 15 by 100 power 2 for 2 years. And then more, we have 4 months. For 4 months, we can write like this. 1 plus rate of interest is 15% per annum. And 4 months in the sense, totally 4 months is 1/3 of the year. So 15 into 1 by 3 divided by 100. Okay, this is the rule to calculate the amount in the compound interest after 2 years and 4 months. Okay, so for 2 years and then for 4 months. So how can we simplify? 3 5s is 25, 5 20s. 3 5s is 15, 5 20s. Now here it will be 15 by 100. Okay, 5 3s and then 5 20s. So this is equals to 8,000 into 23 square divided by 400 into, okay, 5 20s. 20 plus 1, 21 divided by 20. 400 into 20 is 8,000. Then we need to multiply 23 square into 21. This 23 square into 21 is nothing but 11,109. This is the amount. Since 11,109 is the amount in the compound interest, they asked us to calculate the interest. Interest is the difference between these two values, principal and the amount. And your answer is 3,109. Okay? And the next one is 58th problem. For this 58th problem, it is given that A is half good a workman as B. Suppose one day work of B as 1 by X. Since one day work of B is 1 by X, then the one day work of A is 1 by 2X because he is half as good as B. They finish a job in 14 days, both together. That means 1 by X plus 1 by 2X is equals to 1 by 14. One day work of both together is 1 by 14. And on simplification, 2x plus x is 3x, okay, like this, 3x by what, 2x, no, 3 by 2x is equals to 1 by 14, so 2 sevenths, and on simplification, you will get x is equals to 21. Since x is equals to 21, one day work of B is 1 by 21, and the number of days for B to finish the job are 21 days, there ends the problem, okay. And the next one, 59th problem, okay, somewhat a logical tricky problem. On time, problems on trains, it is given that what? A train starts from A to B with 60 kilometers per hour and another train from B to A at the same time. After crossing each other, then they complete their journey in 3 1 by 2 and 2 4 by 7 hours. Then find the speed of the second train. So basically, there are two points A and B. A train starts from A. Okay, a train starts from A. At the speed of 60 kilometers per hour. Suppose that the speed of the first train is S1. Then the speed of the second train is S2. They both start at the same time. Okay. Suppose they will meet at a point C. Since they will meet at the point C after T hours, they will meet at this point after T hours. Anukunte, the first train covers a distance of how much? This is the time, this is the speed, this distance is TS1. This is the time, this is the speed, then this distance is TS2, okay? So after T hours, both the trains are at this point, okay? Now, for the first train, to move from C to B, it takes 3 1/2 hours. And then for the second train, okay, this is first train. And for the second train, to move from C to A, it takes 2 4/7 hours. So this distance is now the second, first train has to move. So this is the distance TS2, this is the time, okay? And the speed of the first train is S1. Whereas this is the distance, this is the time, and the speed of the second train is S2. Once of all, observe that after T hours, first train is at this point, second train is at this point. That means the first train covers TS1 distance, second train covers TS2 distance. After crossing each other, second train has to cover this distance, first train has to cover this distance. This distance is covered by the first train in this much of time. This distance is covered by the second train in this much of the time. This distance has to cover by the first train, its speed is S1. This distance has to covered by the first second train, its distance is S2. Its speed is S2. Now, distance, time and speed. Distance, time and speed. Distance is equals to speed into time. So, TS1 is equals to S2 into 2 4 by 7 means 7 2s is 14 plus 4 is 18 by 7. And now from here, TS2 is equals to 3 1 by 2. 3 2s is 6 plus 1, 7 by 2 into S1. Okay. For suppose if you divide both together, TS1 by TS2 is nothing but S1 by S2 is equals to S2 by S1 into 18 by 7 divided by 7 by 2, which is nothing but 36 by 49. From there, it is clear that S1 square by S2 square is 36 by 49. You will observe that S1 by S2 is equals to 6 by 7. Now, in the problem, they mentioned the speed of this first train is 60, then automatically the speed of second train will become 70. Your answer is 70, okay? 70 kilometers per hour. There is the problem, right? So, this is 59th problem. And the next one, we have to discuss 60th problem. So, what is given in the 60? A bus leaves Guntur at 5 a.m., reaches Vizag at 12 noon. Another bus leaves Vizag at 8 a.m. and reaches Guntur at 3 p.m. The difference between 5 a.m. and 12 noon, okay, is 7 hours, whereas the difference between 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. is also 7 hours, okay? For the bus 1 as well as for the bus 2, the distance is both same, distance between Guntur and Vizag, okay? Then the time taken for the first bus is 7 hours, second bus is also 7 hours. Then automatically, the speeds are also equal, like distance by speed, kilometers per, distance by time, kilometers per hour, like x by 7 kilometers per hour, okay? See, second train starts at 8 a.m. Okay, at 8 a.m., what will happen? At 8 a.m., distance covered by the bus 1. The speed of the bus 1 is x by 7. Okay, and its time is, it starts at 5. Now we are going to calculate at 8. The first bus has moved a distance of a time of 3 hours. Speed is x by 7. Time is 3 hours. So distance covered by the bus 1 up to 8 a.m. is 3x by 7 kilometers. Okay, so if the total distance is considered as x, now at 8 a.m. distance between the buses, distance between bus 1 and bus 2 can be calculated by x minus 3x by 7, which is nothing but 4x by 7. At 8 a.m. the distance between those two buses is calculated as 4x by 7. Now time required to cross each other is nothing but 4x by 7 divided by the, okay, relative speed is nothing but sum of the speeds, which is 2x by 7. If you simplify, you will get it as 2 hours. So after 8 a.m., they require 2 hours to cross each other. So they will meet at 10 a.m. And your answer is 10 a.m. There ends the problem. Okay. And the next one is 61st problem, which is on the area and perimeter of the rhombus. For this problem, the perimeter of the rhombus is given as 146. If you observe a rhombus, in the rhombus, all the sides are equal. It has S and S and S. In the rhombus, the diagonals are also perpendicular to each other and the diagonals bisect each other. That means these two parts are of equal length. These two parts are of equal length. Okay. Now, as per the problem, the diameter is given as 146. So, 4 times of S is given as 146. Then S is equals to, if you divide with 2, you will get it as 73 by 2. S is 73 by 2. One of its diagonal is given as 55. For suppose D1 is equals to 55. We need to calculate D2. In rhombus, this is half of the first diagonal, this is half of the second diagonal, and we have the side. Then by applying Pythagorean result for these three, we have that D1 square plus D2 square is equals to 4S square. What is D1? 55 square plus D2 square is equals to 4 into S square means 73 square by 4. If you calculate, you will get D2 as 48. Okay, by using this Pythagorean result, if you calculate, you will get the length of the diagonal to is 48. So, first diagonal is of length 55, second diagonal is of length 48. We need to calculate area. Area of the rhombus is half D1, D2. So, D1 is 55, D2 is 48, and if you calculate half D1, D2, you will get the answer. There ends the problem, right? And the next one is 62nd problem. For this 62nd problem, a road roller of diameter 1.7 meters, length 7 meters and length 1 meter has to press a ground of area 1100 square meters. How many revolutions does it make? A road roller in one revolution, okay, it presses an area equal to its curved surface area. So the lateral surface area or curved surface area, both are same. So in one revolution, the road roller covers a distance, an area equal to its curved surface area. So in one revolution, it covers, okay, area equals to its curved surface area, whose rule is 2 pi RH, that is equals to 2 into 22 by 7 into diameter is given as 1.75. Okay, so 1.75 by 100, whereas radius is given as 1.7 by 200 and height is 1. We need to simplify. How can we calculate? This is 25 eighths and then 25 sevenths. 7 and 7 will get cancelled to 4s, and if you simplify, you will get it as 11 by 2 square meters. So in one revolution, it covers area equals to 11 by 2 square meters. Then total number of revolutions is nothing but total area is given as what? 11,000 square meters divided by the 11 by 2, 1100 by 11 by 2. And on simplification, you will get it as 200. So the road roller requires 200 revolutions to cover the road of area 1100 square meters. There is the problem. Okay. In one revolution, curved surface area, number of revolutions is total area by area covered in one revolution. And the next one is 63rd problem, which is given that tan 80 degrees minus tan 70 degrees, tan 10 degrees divided by tan 70 degrees we need to find. You need to calculate this one. First of all, we know that 80 minus 10 is equals to 70. Then apply tan for this one. Tan of 80 minus 10 is equals to tan 70. Now utilize tan of A minus B formula for this left hand side, which is nothing but tan 80 minus tan 70 divided by 1 plus tan 80 into tan 10 is equals to tan 70. Tan A minus tan B by 1 plus tan A tan B is equals to tan 70. Now we need tan 80 minus tan 10 by tan 70. So send this tan 70 this side and this value that side. So that will be, this is tan 70 and this is tan 80 into tan 10 plus 1. Now this product value is also 1. Because 80 plus 10 is 90, tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta, and tan theta into cot theta is 1. Using these two results, tan 10 into tan 80 will be 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2 and your answer is 2. There ends the problem. Okay. And the next one is 64th problem. A direct question. The length of each side of an equilateral triangle is root 6 and they ask us to calculate its circumradius. The circumradius capital R of an equilateral triangle. Capital R of an equilateral triangle is nothing but 1 by root 3a. Okay. See, actually, that was 2/3 of its height anamata. 2/3 of height of the equilateral triangle is root 3 by 2a. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. On simplification, you get it as a by root 3. So, which is nothing but root 6 by root 3. On simplification, you get it as root 2. So, the circumradius of the equilateral triangle is root 2. So, we need to memorize that the circumradius of an equilateral triangle is 2 by 3 times of its height. After that, 65th problem. For this, sides of two similar triangles are in the ratio 4:9. They ask us to find the ratio between their areas. So, since sides are in the ratio 4:9, automatically areas of similar triangles are in the ratio of the squares of their sides, and your answer is 16:81. And the next one. PA and PB are two tangents drawn to the circle from an external point. PA is given. They ask us to calculate PB. So, a direct simple question. If you have a circle from an external point, we can draw two tangents for the circle. And the lengths of these two tangents are equal. This length is given as 5 and they ask us to calculate this length. Since both are equal, PB is also 5. Okay. And the next one is 67th problem. For this 67th problem, the areas of three adjacent faces of a cuboid are x, y, z respectively. Suppose that initially, let the dimensions of the cuboid, just like this room, suppose the dimensions are LBH, length, breadth and height. Okay. So, the areas of three adjacent faces, like for example, we are here, area of the floor, area of this wall and area of that wall are given as x, y, z. Area of the floor is usually considered as LB. That area LB is given as x. Area of that wall is considered as BH, which is given as y. Area of this wall is considered as HL, which is given as z. They ask us to calculate volume. If you multiply all these things, L square, B square, H square is equals to XYZ. And we know volume is equals to LBH. LBH is nothing but root of XYZ. And your answer is root XYZ. This is 67th problem. Right? And the next one is 68th problem. For this 68th problem, Okay, the diagram is the important task to solve these type of problems. The height of a tower is 100 meters. Suppose a tower of height 100 meters. When the angle of elevation of the sun changes from 30 degrees to 45 degrees, the shadow of the tower becomes x meters less. Okay, so at a point, the angle of elevation is 30 degrees. Okay, if it changes from 30 to 45, the length of this shadow is decreased by x. The new length is this one. Okay, what is the value of x we need to find? Since this angle is 45 degrees, these two sides must equal, this is also 100. Now, apply tan 30. Tan 30 degrees is equals to opposite side divided by the adjacent side 100 plus x. And we know tan 30 degrees is 1 by root 3. If you solve, you will get the x, and that x will be option A or option B, both A and B. Okay? Then the next one is 69th problem. 69th problem is a somewhat different problem, which is given that 0 less than, A less than, B less than, C less than, D. And they asked us which among the following has the least. There are certain fractions that are given. We need to find out the least value. Okay? To find the least value of a fraction, numerator must be less and denominator must be more. Among these three, the smaller values are A and B. So the numerator must be A plus B, whereas the larger values are C and D, the denominator must be C plus D. If the numerator is less and denominator is more, automatically the value will become lesser. The value will become lesser. So your lesser value is A plus B by C plus D, which was option A. Okay. And the next one is 70th problem. For the 70th problem, a transport company's van each carry a maximum load of 12 tons. Okay, for a trip, it carries a load of 12 tons. 24 sealed boxes, each weighing 5 tons. One box weighs 5 tons. Okay, so in one load, it carries maximum 12 tons. So each box is weighing 5 tons. So maximum, it carries only 2 boxes in one trip anamata, because its weight is 10. Okay, third box tiskunte, it becomes 15 tons, but the van has not that much of capacity. Okay, so it covers maximum 2 boxes in one trip. Since it covers maximum 2 boxes in one trip, to cover the total 24 boxes, we need 12 trips, and your answer is 12. There is the problem. Then, from 71 to 75, a pie diagram is given indicating the total expenditure of 5,40,000 on different items in constructing a flat. Okay, the labor charge, timber charge, cement charge, as well as bricks, steel is given. Okay, see, the labor is given as 100 degrees. Okay, it must be printed as 100 degrees. Okay, but it is printed as 100%. You treat it as 100 degrees. 100 degrees, 90 degrees, 75 degrees, 50 degrees, and steel is 45 degrees. So for the 71st problem, okay, the expenditure on bricks we need to calculate. The value at the bricks is 50 degrees out of 360 degrees. Okay, 50 degrees out of 360 degrees, and the total value is given as 5,40,000. Okay, if you simplify, you will get your answer directly. Okay, which is 75,000. And the next one is, the expenditure on bricks is less than the expenditure on timber by, is the question. Okay, 71st, second one. The expenditure on bricks is 50 degrees, whereas the expenditure on timber is 90 degrees. The difference is 40 degrees. We need to calculate the value corresponding to 40 degrees out of 360 degrees from a total amount of 5,40,000. If you calculate, you will get the answer. Okay. And the next one is 73rd problem. The percentage of the total expenditure spent on the steel and cement we need to calculate. Spent on steel and cement. Steel is 45, cement is 75 degrees. The value is 120 degrees. We need to calculate the percentage. So 120 degrees by 360 degrees into 100 we need to calculate. So 1 by 3 into 100, which is 33.3%. There is the problem. Okay. Then, which is the item of maximum expenditure? Clearly, labor has 100 degrees, so it must have maximum expenditure. Okay, then the last one is 75th problem. The expenditure on cement we need to calculate. So the value for the cement is 75 degrees. So we need to calculate 75 by 360 into the amount, and you will get the answer. Okay, so finally, this is the explanation for the quantitative questions from the CGL 35th paper. Thank you. Thank you very much.